We're going to talk about locking screens and pushing URLs using the Securely Device Console teacher tools. There may be times that you need to get your students' attention so that they're not looking at their device, but rather looking at you. Or you want them to not use their device for a particular activity. This is using the screen lock tool. At the very top of your teacher tool screen, you'll notice screen lock. If I want to lock all student devices, I can simply click on screen lock. And it says, do you want to apply screen lock to all devices? If you do want to lock all devices, you'll click yes. And you can put a message in here. What do you want it to say on the student's device? Now, the default is your screen has been locked by your teacher, but maybe I want to give them a different direction. After you've typed in your message, you will click screen lock. I want you to note what happens on the device to the right. The message that I placed shows up on that screen. The student is unable to go to other tabs. If they do, they'll get that same message on each tab. You'll notice on your Teacher Tools page, when a device is locked, you'll see an orange screen lock. This is indicative that that student's screen is locked. In order to release their screens, you're going to need to use the release button. When you click release, you can apply release to all devices. Then the students will be able to get their devices back and have control again. Now, there may be a time when you only want to lock a few student devices, one or more. You can actually select a student first, or students, and click screen lock. That will only lock that particular student's device. When you're ready to release, simply release the devices. This is a great tool to use in face-to-face instruction. There may be times when you can use it for remote instruction. However, we want to give you a little warning. If you're doing a Google Meet session and you're using these tools and you lock your student's screen, they're not going to be able to use their device to do whatever it is that you wanted them to do if they're remote. They also may lose connectivity to your Google Meet. So just a thought, this tool is much better served in a face-to-face classroom than in a remote or hybrid environment for as far as locking. So you may want to lock the screens of the students who are present in the room in order to get that same feel. But the students who are remote will then lose access to your Google Meet. So that's screen locking. Now let's talk about pushing URLs. There may be a time that you want your students to go to a particular site. In the past, you've probably created a document and had the links on it that you wanted your students to go to, but now you can actually make it faster and instruct more quickly by pushing that URL to the student's device. So I can click on Push URL. It asks me if I want to apply it to all students in the class. I can say yes. And then at the top, I can put in a particular site that I want them to go to. So this is not a very good example, but maybe I want them to go to google.com. The URL goes in the top field, the name goes in the bottom. We'll talk about the web links later. So once I've done this, I can click Push URL, and you can see what happens with my device on the right. It will take them directly to google.com. Now, if I wanted to do this on only one device, I would simply click the student and then choose Push URL. So if there's a particular site that this student needs to go to, I can push that to that particular student. So this gives you some ideas of how you can lock screens and push things to a student's device, making it really supportive for instruction.